Hello and welcome to The Big Fight, a show that is young at 21, the oldest running debate show on Indian news television. I'm Sanket Upadhyay. The farmers' government impasse, or the face-off, has shown no signs of ebbing. In fact, this seems to be the one problem that doesn't have a vaccine, since we are talking about vaccine. And nothing is in sight anytime soon as well. Over 10 rounds of talks have failed, and the confrontation peaked last week when there were allegations that this is an international conspiracy to malign India. This after singer Rihanna and environmentalist Greta Thunberg's tweets supporting the farmers' agitation. The government says a toolkit of what to do proves that this is not much about farmers but a well-funded enterprise of those who want to show India in poor light. Naturally, questions are being asked on whether we are that fragile a country to be broken by tweets. And amid all of this, have we forgotten the real concern, the real issue, the farmers' concern and the government solutions? So on The Big Fight tonight, we believe that our country, India, was, is and always be above anyone's tweets, anyone's propaganda, international or state, anyone's criticism, anyone's praise. But what will make us bigger and better, perhaps, will be an attempt to answer the core issue and address the problem, to look for solutions to this impasse. The honour versus insecurity debate is going to begin in just a short moment, and a little while later, we'll have Dr. Shashi Tharoor, a diplomat, a politician, a keen observer of India abroad, and most recently a recipient of an FIR, speaks about India's image and who is damaging it more. We also speak to Haryana leader Dipender Singh Hooda on the political impact of these protests on the alliance in Haryana. So let us kick off The Big Fight Special Edition. I have with me, and we'll begin with the man of the moment, BKO leader Rakesh Tikait. He's now with us. Tikait saab, aapka NDTV se baat karne ke liye bahut bahut dhanyawad. Main kal Sisoli ghoom ke aaya.
Dhanyawad, dhanyawad.
Main kal Sisoli ghoom ke aaya tha, meri chaudhari Naresh Singh Tikait se bhi baat hui. और ऐसा लग रहा है कि अब गांव में पश्चिमी उत्तर प्रदेश में जिस तरीके से आप महापंचायत कर रहे हैं, आपने एक तरीके से मन बना लिया है कि अब एक जिद ठान ली है कि अब किसी भी हाल में ये करना ही करना, क्या ऐसा है?
नहीं, एक बात तो बताओ, क्या बिल वापसी में क्या दिक्कत है ये तो बताओ ना। जब बिल किसान की सहमति से नहीं बना, किसान के फायदे का बताते हैं, किसान उसे चाहता नहीं, तो उनको वापसी दे लो, एमएसपी पर कानून बना दो, उसमें क्या दिक्कत है? ये बता दो भाई, ये समस्या है। हम आंदोलन तो कर रहे हैं, कुछ और थोड़ा कर रहे हैं हम।
नहीं, ठीक है सर, आपने सरकार से कितने 11-12 बार बात की है, उनका ये कहना है कि आप आइए चर्चा कर लीजिए, खंडवार बात कीजिए, ये कानून वापस करने की जिद पर क्यों अड़े हुए हैं? और अब तो ये देखिए, एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय एक रणनीति की आप मिले हुए हैं, एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय बदनाम करने की एक साजिश है जिसके तहत ये सब हो रहा है, इस पर आप क्या कहेंगे?
नहीं, कौन है अंतर्राष्ट्रीय भाई? नहीं, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय कौन है, कहां अंतर्राष्ट्रीय वो करने की कोशिश कौन कर रहा? ये तो बिल वापसी की बात है, आधे रेट में किसान अपनी फसलों को बेच रहा है, ये तो सवाल उसका है, किसान का सवाल है, उसका भाव नहीं मिल रहा उसका सवाल है। ये जो पूरे देश में आंदोलन चल रहे हैं, क्या कर्नाटक से लगाकर छत्तीसगढ़ और झारखंड जो लोग खड़े हुए हैं, जिनको कीमतें नहीं मिल रही, अगर उसने कीमत मांग ली तो इसमें कोई बदनामी होगी देश की? ये तो पहली बार सुनने का किसान अपनी कीमत मांग रहा है कि उसमें इंटरनेशनल बदनामी हो रही है, ये तो कोई सवाल समझ में आया नहीं। तीन बिल गोदाम पहले बन गए, क्या गोदाम वालों को पता था क्या कि बिल आएगा इस तरह का बिल बनना है?
नहीं, ठीक है सर, आप जो मांग रहे हैं वो ये है कि किसानों को उनका भाव मिले, सही भाव मिले, कौड़ियों के दाम ना जाए फसल, सही बात है ना? तो सरकार का ये कहना है जब प्राइवेट प्लेयर आएंगे तो आपको मनमानी कीमत मिलेगी, अब आप किसी, आपको आजादी होगी, अच्छा? किसी को भी बेच लो।
ओ, अच्छा, बहुत बड़ा गणित लगा रहे हो, कौन है गणित मास्टर? मतलब जो सरकार ने जो भाव कहा, हमने यही तो कहा कि आप उस पर कानून बना दो कि उससे कंपनी लेगा कोई भी। अभी भी तो व्यापारी खरीद रहा है, कोई किसान अपने घर में रख रहा है अभी भी, अभी आधे में लूट रहा है ना, जो दूसरा बड़ा लुटेरा आ जाएगा वो ठीक लूटेगा, मतलब कोई कंपटीशन करेंगे ये। आज भी आधे रेट में जो एमएसपी से कम पे खरीद हो रही, अगर कानून होता तो किसान को भाव मिल जाता, कानून नहीं है तो इसीलिए तो उनको सपोर्ट हो रही है कि कानून नहीं है, किसान को लूट लो। ये एक बड़ा षड्यंत्र किसान के साथ में हो रहा है, ये उसी के लिए ये आंदोलन है।
अच्छा राकेश जी, गेहूं
का रेट देश में एक होगा, बिजली के रेट अलग अलग होंगे।
हाँ, हाँ। राकेश जी, अब मैं आपसे एक महत्वपूर्ण सवाल पूछना चाहता हूँ, और वो ये कि इसका राजनीति पे क्या असर पड़ेगा। ये जो महापंचायत हो रही है, इसमें मैं देख रहा हूँ, वहां पर मैंने सुना भी लोग सिसौली, मुजफ्फरनगर, शामली, इन सब इलाके में ये कह रहे हैं कि 2013 में जो कुछ भी हुआ था, जो भी घटना हुई थी, अब उसे भूल करके सारे किसानों को एक मंच पे महापंचायत में आना पड़ेगा। तो आपको लगता है कि इसका जवाब आप राजनीतिक रूप से भी दे सकते हैं? ये तो हक है ही आपके पास, वोट पे दे दीजिएगा, सड़कों पे क्यों बैठे?
नहीं नहीं, राजनीति का तो हमें पता नहीं, ना हम राजनीति की बात करते, ना हम किसी को वोट में तब्दील कह रहे, ना हम किसी को वोट कहते कि भाई तू किसको दर किसका नो दे। हम तो आंदोलन कर रहे हैं, अपनी बात रख रहे हैं, और सड़क पर बैठ के कर रहे हैं, दिल्ली के गेट पर कर रहे हैं, दिल्ली के दरवाजे पे बैठे, क्योंकि दिल्ली ही देगी इसलिए बैठे वहां पे।
कब तक करेंगे
ये तो लंबा चलेगा।
नहीं, तैयारी कब तक की है, क्योंकि सरकार ने तो मन बना लिया है, आपने देख लिया वो रवैया साफ तय कर लिया उन्होंने।
मन किसान ने भी बना लिया भाई, मन किसान ने भी बना लिया, किसान भी वापसी नहीं आएगा, मन किसान ने भी बना लिया।
नहीं लेकिन राकेश जी, फिर हल कैसे निकलेगा? आप कह रहे हैं आपने मन बना लिया, सरकार कह रही है।
सरकार भाई, हर हल हमारे हाथ में है क्या, ये बताओ? सरकार के ही तो हाथ में है ना हल।
नहीं नहीं, देखिए अभी ऐसा हो रहा है, अभी ऐसा हो रहा है कि अड़ी सरकार और टिके टिकैत, अब ऐसी स्थिति में हल कहां से निकले?
अच्छा बताओ भाई, अब भाई हमारे पे क्या इलाज है, वो इलाज बता दो। मतलब सरकार हटेगी नहीं, जो कानून को वापसी ले सकती है, किसान बर्बाद हो जाए, ये गणित तो समझ में आई नहीं हमारी। 350% का इंटरेस्ट देता है किसान, 1,00,000 रुपए के एक रात के 10,000 रुपए दे जाता है, कोई है सुनने वाला? किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड में पूरे देश के किसान को बर्बाद कर दिया पॉलिसी ने। सरकार भाव तय करती है और कम रेट पे बिकता है, फार्मूला गलत है पूर्ण रूप से। किसके सामने कहेंगे? सड़क पे ही तो कहेंगे आन के। हाँ, हाँ। कैसे सुनना चाहती है सरकार? हाँ। भाई सड़क पे ही बैठ के तो अपनी बात करेंगे।
हाँ। अच्छा मैं एक सवाल आपसे पूछना चाहता हूँ। जी राकेश जी, मेरा आपसे आखिरी एक आधा सवाल, ये जो महापंचायत हो रही है, इनका क्या उद्देश्य? क्योंकि शुरुआत में तो नहीं हो रही थी, हम देख रहे हैं कि वो तो जब आपके अश्रु बह गए, जब आप रोने लगे, उसके बाद से मैं देख रहा हूँ एक के बाद एक महापंचायत होती जा रही है।
ये गुस्सा है, किसान बर्बाद हो गया, गांव का किसान बर्बाद हो गया, फसलों के रेट नहीं मिल रहे उसके, गन्ना एक्ट, गन्ना कानून, धज्जियां उड़ रही हैं। सरकार ने रेट तय करा, सरकार ने गन्ना एक्ट बनाया, उसमें कहा कि 14 दिन में भुगतान होगा, नहीं हो रहा भुगतान। हमको भी जोड़ दो डिजिटल इंडिया से, हमको भी जोड़ दो, किसान भी जुड़ जाएगा उससे, हमारा भी, हम गन्ना डाल दें हमारे अकाउंट में साथ ही पैसा पहुंच जाए, बैंकिंग सिस्टम तो सेम ही होगा, पेट्रोल पंप जुड़ सकता है, एक रेहड़ी लगाने वाला जुड़ सकता है, मशीन रख सकता है, वो पेटीएम सर उससे पैसा ले दे सकता है, लेकिन किसान पे बंदिश है। ये खुलासे होंगे सारे,
ठीक है,
देश पूरा बर्बाद हुआ है, किसान तबाह हो गया है, उसकी जमीनों के ऊपर नजरें हैं, किसान जमीन नहीं छोड़ेगा।
चलिए
ये आंदोलन चलेगा, अब ये मिट्टी से मिट्टी से आंदोलन चलेगा, इसी खेत की मिट्टी से ही आंदोलन चलेगा पूरे देश में।
मेरा आखिरी सवाल आपसे, मैं देखा आज आपने मिट्टी गिराई, कुछ फूल वूल लगा दिए, जहां पर कील लगी थी वहां आपने गुलाब खिला दिए, तो ये जो गुलाब की खुशबू है ये किस चीज का प्रतीक है, क्या बताना चाहते हैं आप?
भाई वे कील लगाएंगे, हम बीज बोएंगे, वे कील बोएंगे हम बीज बोएंगे, ये शांति का प्रतीक है।
ठीक, राकेश टिकैत जी आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद बिग फाइट में बात करने के लिए। दैट वाज बीकेयू लीडर राकेश टिकैत स्पीकिंग टू अस सेइंग दैट यू इंस्टॉल नेल्स, वी आर गोइंग टू ग्रो फ्लावर्स बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट वी डू। नाउ हाउ इज दिस गोइंग टू वर्क आउट, नोबडी नोज। आई गेस इवन द फार्म लीडर्स डू नॉट नो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन। बट यू नो द लार्जर पॉइंट ऑन ऑनर वर्सेज इनसिक्योरिटी, where is this going, where is the protest going, and more importantly where is the narrative and the discourse going? Let's put that to a discussion. I have with me Mr. Naresh Sirohi, National Vice President of the BJP Kisan Morcha, Satyapal Jain, Additional Solicitor General of India and member of the Bharatiya Janata Party National Executive Committee, Maheshinder Grewal, Akali Dal spokesperson, Ravinder Singh Cheema, Vice President of the Rashtriya Arathiya Kisan Sangh. Thank you very much to all of you for joining us. Let me first begin with you, Satyapal Jain ji, good to have you back on the show. Mr. Jain, you just heard the farmer leaders, right? You have seen the resentment, the anger of the people. As someone who knows Punjab very closely, you're a resident of Chandigarh, how would you respond to this massive resentment against the government? And to top it all, now you have a narrative discourse, you know, an honor versus insecurity debate happening on Twitter.
I'd like to make two submissions.
Sure.
Number one, in reply to your first question that there is a resentment, as a matter of fact, in Punjab, all the major political parties,
Congress, Aam Aadmi Party, Akali Dal, CPM, CPI, except the BJP, all the parties are opposing the farm laws for their own reasons. I'm not going into the justification at the moment or non-justification. So that is the reason they have been able to create an impression as a today, Mr. Tomar said in Rajya Sabha, they have been able to create an impression among the farming community. So it is because of the fact that all anti-BJP, anti-Modi forces are joining hands. And because in Punjab, there is a peculiar social structure, political structure, where BJP has never been a force number one. It has always been a force allied with the Akali Dal. So that is one of the reasons. But anyhow, so far as the issue is concerned, let me make things very clear. The government of India held discussions with them not once, twice, thrice, four times, but 10, 11 times on all the issues. The Supreme Court also formed a committee. The Supreme Court, as a matter of fact, have put all the laws on hold. So as a matter of fact, today those laws are not enforced. They are not enforced. Can you imagine, have you ever heard of any agitation where one side says, accept 100% whatever I am saying, you will not have even 0% say in the adjustment, compromise or settlement. Whatever I say, if it is acceptable, then we will agree. Otherwise, we will not agree.
No, Mr. Jain, I'll tell you where does this all flows out of trust, the lack of it for that matter. I spoke to a lot of farmer leaders after traveling to Western UP. I spoke to a lot of farmer leaders who are positioned on these borders, and they say that it all boils down to trust. You say that nothing wrong will happen, the farmer's interest is going to be protected, but when corporates will come in, the rules of the private sector will apply and eventually the farmers will lose their land. Now, whether this will happen or not, nobody knows, but there is a fear. Do you feel that the biggest failing of the BJP or of the present dispensation is that you have not been able to allay these fears well?
No, I don't call it a failure on the part of the BJP or the central government. The central government has made it clear not once, twice, thrice, but a number of times. Today also, Mr. Tomar, in his speech in parliament, and I appreciate him, he replied to each and every point which has been agitated against the farm laws in Rajya Sabha today. I will call him man of the match today, the address he gave.
No,
today.
But Mr. Jain, he said that this is restricted to Punjab. That's not the case. It's happening in Haryana. It's happening in Western UP.
He says mostly it is in the Punjab and Haryana, some part of Haryana.
No, but
also.
Now these Mahapanchayats are happening in Western UP. Okay. It happened in Shamli.
They can hold it, no problem. Mahapanchayats have been held earlier also. It will be continuing in future also. But the point is, the leadership of the agitationists, they have not been able to carry their flock with them. You see what happened in Delhi on that day, Lal Qila. What happened in other parts of the Delhi. All the leaders on the same day were not in a position to own whatever happened there. In case they come to an agreement, they may not be able to take their flock together with them.
Okay.
And I think now the best time for the agitationists is to suspend their agitation, keeping in view the incident of violence in Lal Qila and Delhi, resume the talks with the central government. Central government has also already offered, we will put on hold for 1.5 years.
Sure.
MSP will be ensured. If they want more time, let them come.
Okay.
The only solution to the problem is come on the negotiating table and like Mahatma Gandhi
did before
the Chora when violence erupted, suspend your agitation. Only then you will be able to have a dialogue and come to a solution.
I agree with you. Talks and dialogue can only be the way forward. But as of this moment, a function which is bigger than talks, for talks to happen, is trust. And I guess with that trust deficit, this is a big challenge. And being government, I guess this will be a big challenge for you, more than the protesters. Let me quickly go across to Mr. Garewal also, and then I'll come back to you. Mr. Garewal, you've seen that of late the discourse, particularly over these past 4 or 5 days, has been more about, you know, who's maligning whom internationally, who's tweeting what, and which tweet has more impact, what the real intention is, and the fact that this is all about insulting India. Mr. Garewal, I want to know your view. Whose honor are we defending, and who's insecure?
I think government just wants to divert the attention of the people by making certain allegations, which I don't think has any force, that Rihanna or the Greta tweet will create a mess for Indian security. I think India is not that weak country that these two tweets by either Rihanna or that young girl Greta can cause any problem. Moreover, if government has any specific evidence that some forces from outside are trying to infiltrate into the peaceful movement of the farmers, the government should take them to task, but they should not blame the farmers. I don't think we have seen in my life such a peaceful, such a well-attended and longest protest which the farmers are continuing.
No, no, but then government, the protest was not peaceful. No, if you talk to the government, they will say the events of 26 January make it clear that the protest was not peaceful.
No, see, Sanket, one thing is very clear. We should see it very clearly that what happened on 26th of January, that government allowed to happen. And it was on your channel I heard one former CP of Delhi. He said that crowd was too big and the government at back of mind was having an apprehension that they are unmanageable crowd and they may not rush towards the Rajpath.
Okay.
So they allowed them to have their own way.
Okay.
And
okay.
That is why
very
police
quickly,
never resisted to the crowd.
I want to go back to happened. Mr. Jain,
yes,
very quickly.
Nobody can condone
sure,
that. The violence.
Sure. Let me go back.
Akali Dal certainly condemns
it. No, nobody will support
but
violence. Nobody is also. Not even the farmers who are protesting.
Few hundred people.
Mr. Jain,
out
very quickly.
Of the lakhs of people. Should not give bad name to the farmers.
Okay. Mr. Jain, I want to come back to you. Your right to reply on this whole point of responding to tweets. I mean, an FIR against Greta Thunberg, toolkit controversy. I mean, we all know, and I'm sure you also know, for any campaign to be managed and escalated, you need certain rules in place. I'm sure when the government decided to go all out, you know, to build a counter narrative, it too must have had some plan, i.e. a toolkit, to promote hashtags like India Together and India Against Propaganda.
See, I agree with Mr. Garewal that India is strong enough to meet all sort of challenges from any forces, maybe known, maybe unknown, maybe coming on the surface, may not be coming on the surface. If we can meet the threat from China, Pakistan, we can meet the threat from the international conspirators also. But that doesn't mean that we should ignore such attempts. A single tweet sometimes can lead to many, many serious law and order problems. You can't ignore that. And since the matter is under investigation, Government of India has all the information. It will come out with all the details. But I think all those people who want India to be a strong country, we may have internal differences. We may have different approach on the foreign
law. No, but then, you know, but Mr. Jain, as a law officer,
foreign agencies,
as an officer of the law, Mr. Jain, as an officer of the law, I want to ask you, when someone says that I support this protest, whether that person is in India or abroad, how exactly can this be called a conspiracy? What is the conspiracy in supporting a protest? And how can this spiral out of control?
So far as the Indian citizens are concerned, within the framework of the Constitution, you have every right to have your point of view, to express it in any manner you want to express, subject to law and order problem, constitutional limitations. But we cannot allow foreign citizens who are not citizens of India to interfere in the internal working of the India. Today it is one
Mr.
person.
Mr. Jain, we as a country comment on other countries. Did we not comment on what happened in Capitol Hill or what happened in Myanmar?
See, so far as these comments have to be as per the policy of the Government of India. It has to be an official comment. No Indian citizen can to comment in any situation, and especially in a situation where there has been a violence in Delhi, violence on Lal Killa.
Sure.
Number of such apprehensions are there in such a situation.
No, because the criticism is that this is not much about defending India's honor. First of all, criticism of the government is not criticism of the country. So that these are two.
They are not only
different.
Criticizing the government, they are casting aspersion on the system, on the country, on the nation. And still matter is under investigation. It is under investigation. We will come out with all the evidence that we have,
sure,
with all the information that we have. Why are they so afraid of the investigation?
Sure.
Even at the initial stage,
the allegation
will come
is
in the public domain.
The allegation, that's why this becomes a debate about protecting an honor, and the other side saying that this is nothing but a government's insecurity at play. You want to control
the narrative. No question of insecurity. India is strong enough. Government of India is strong
enough
exactly
to face
any challenge from any side.
India is so strong that we do not have to worry about anyone's propaganda.
But that doesn't mean that we can ignore such type of things.
Okay. Mr. Naresh Sirohi as well as Mr. Cheema, one by one. Mr. Cheema, I'll come to you first. I want to know from you the impact on the ground. Now, initially it was said that this is a protest largely restricted to Punjab. Now we are saying that there are protests and Mahapanchayats taking place in Haryana as well as in Western UP. There is a feeling that, at least in a section, that all of this is being engineered and it's not organic.
Sanket ji, jahan tak is sangharsh ko Punjab ya Haryana tak simit karne ki baat hai, ye bahut baar सरकार द्वारा मंत्रियों द्वारा कहा जाता है, लेकिन मैं स्पष्ट करना चाहता हूं कि ये आंदोलन पंजाब और हरियाणा का अब नहीं है, ये आंदोलन पूरे देश में फैल चुका है, इसमें कोई दो राय नहीं, क्योंकि दिल्ली के नजदीक पंजाब हरियाणा यूपी राजस्थान नजदीक पड़ते हैं, तो यहाँ के किसानों का ट्रैक्टरों से पहुंचना, अपने व्हीकल से पहुंचना आसान है, उनका दो चार दिन के बाद अपने गांव वापस चले जाना, रोटेशन होनी गांव से यहां से आसान है, इसलिए पार्टिसिपेंट ज्यादा इन प्रांतों से है, लेकिन ये बात नहीं है कि ये इन प्रांतों का ही आंदोलन है, ये आंदोलन अब पूरे देश का है
जी।
हाँ, जहां तक बात जागृति की है, क्योंकि पंजाब हरियाणा वेस्टर्न यूपी ईस्टर्न राजस्थान सम पार्ट ऑफ एमपी, यहां पे एमएसपी है और एमएसपी देने के लिए जो असिस्ट करता है वो आरतिया है, आरतिया इन पांचों प्रांतों में है और असिस्ट करता है, और जब गवर्नमेंट कहती है कि बिचौलिया खत्म करना है, इट मींस के आरतिया खत्म करना चाहती है। तो मैं एक एग्जांपल पूरे देश में जैन साहब से पूछता हूं कि सिर्फ इन प्रांतों में आरतिया होने की वजह से एमएसपी किसानों के पास जाती है, और आप सबसे पहले प्रधानमंत्री जी भी बोलते हैं बिचौलिया खत्म करेंगे, आपके जितने प्रवक्ता हैं वो बोलते हैं बिचौलिया खत्म करेंगे।
मैं ये इसका जवाब ले लूं, लेट मी टेक अ रिप्लाई फ्रॉम मिस्टर नरेश सिरोही। सिरोही जी, आप जवाब देना चाहेंगे चीमा जी को?
देखिए संकेत जी, जिस तरह का ये पूरा आंदोलन हो गया है, आप पूरे घटनाक्रम से वाकिफ है और पूरा देश इस वाकिफ है और चिंतित है कि किसानों का जो प्रोटेस्ट है वो जिस दिशा में जा रहा है और जिस तरह से बढ़ता हुआ जा रहा है, हमको आपसी सौहार्द बना के उस बातचीत के लाके और किसानों की जो वास्तविक चिंताएं उस पर फोकस करना चाहिए। मेरा किसान आंदोलन के नेताओं से भी आग्रह रहा है, अपनी सरकार से भी मैं लगातार बात कर रहा हूं कि जिस तरह से 26 तारीख में जो भी साजिश लाल किले पे हुई उससे पूरे देश की आत्मा रोई है, किसान की आत्मा रोई है, तो उस बात को हम भूले नहीं थे। लेकिन प्रधानमंत्री जी ने अगले दिन जिस तरह का सकारात्मक बयान दिया, उसके बाद राकेश टिकैत ने कहा कि प्रधानमंत्री का सम्मान नहीं गिरने देंगे, हमें उसी दिशा में आपसी विश्वास और सौहार्द बना के बातचीत पे फोकस करना चाहिए। दुनिया की तमाम ताकतें इस आंदोलन की आड़ में अपनी रोटियां सेकना चाहेंगी, इसमें कहीं कोई दो राय नहीं है, और उनका काम है, विपक्ष का भी अपना काम है कि वो अपना काम करे, वो जो कर सकता है वो करे, लेकिन हम लोगों की जिम्मेवारी ज्यादा है और किसान संगठनों की जिम्मेवारी है कि पूरा जीवन उन लोगों ने किसान आंदोलन में लगाया।
लेकिन ऐसा है सिरोही जी, ये तो सवाल सरकार से ही उठाए जाएंगे ना, अगर अगर लोग अपनी अपनी रोटियां सेक रहे हैं, देयर आर पीपल हु आर ट्राइंग टू यूज द फिश इन ट्रबल वाटर्स इज बिकॉज दैट देयर आर ट्रबल वाटर्स एंड वी हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू फिक्स द प्रॉब्लम इन टाइम। लेकिन जब हम ट्वीट के पीछे चले जाएंगे और लोगों मतलब लोगों के ट्वीट पर FIR करने लगेंगे तो क्या छवि जाएगी?
संकेत जी ना, संकेत जी ना, तो मैं इस बात का पक्षधर हूं कि इस विषय को हम ट्वीट के पीछे ले जाएं, ना मैं इस बात का पक्षधर हूं कि इसमें विपक्ष क्या कह रहा है उस पर हम गौर करें बहुत ज्यादा। हम विपक्ष के बहुत सारी कमजोरियों को भी जानते हैं, उन्होंने कृषि के क्षेत्र में क्या अच्छा किया है क्या बुरा किया है, दोनों
संकेत जी पूरे
देश के सामने ये बात है कि किसान ने कृषि के लिए क्या क्या होना चाहिए। आज एक बात बड़ी बात यह है कि पूरे देश का किसान घाटे की खेती करता है, कोई ऐसा व्यापारी या ऐसा कोई वर्ग नहीं है जो लगातार घाटे की खेती कर सके।
बिल्कुल,
सरकार के उसमें कुछ तरह के प्रयास हुए हैं।
Which is exactly why I come back to the word that I used at the beginning, trust. The problem is a trust deficit. You fix trust and then automatically things will get better.
इसीलिए कह रहा हूं मैं, हम दोनों पक्षों का काम है कि आपसी विश्वास कायम करें। ये एक जरूरी बात है।
परगट जी के पास जाना चाहता हूं। परगट जी, आई वांट टू नो फ्रॉम यू, देखिए भरोसे की कमी ये एक बहुत बड़ी बात उभर करके आई है किसानों की तरफ से भी, लेकिन मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहता हूं कि बजाय इसके कि हम ट्वीट के पीछे भागें, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय क्या कॉन्स्पिरेसी हो रही है उसके पीछे भागें, इसके दो ही पक्षकार हैं, ओनली टू स्टेक होल्डर्स, गवर्नमेंट एंड फार्मर्स। अगर यही लोग आपस में बात करते रहें और ये चैनल चलता रहे तो कभी कोई प्रॉब्लम आएगी नहीं। आपको लगता है हम भटक रहे हैं एज अ गवर्नमेंट?
देखिए संकेत जी,
हाँ बताइए।
हेलो
जी, बोलिए बोलिए।
देखिए जहां तक बात विश्वास की है, हम किसान जथेबंदियों की तरफ से कोई जब भी बात की सरकार ने बात की है, हम बात के लिए आगे आए हैं, कभी भी बात से पीछे नहीं हटे हैं। लेकर विश्वास की जो बोला जा रहा है प्रधानमंत्री जी ने जब बोला है कि फोन की बात है तो हेलो
जी जी आवाज आ रही है, बताएं।
जब उन्होंने बोला है तो उसके बाद हमें क्या मिला है? हमें उसके बाद हमारे कांटे बिछाए जा रहे हैं, हमारा इंटरनेट बंद कर दिया गया है, हमें सभी घेराबंदी हमारी की जा रही है। ये विश्वास की बात नहीं है ना। विश्वास तो ये होता है कि हम बातचीत की बात कर रहे हैं तो बात करने की बात आए।
पर सरकार का कहना है कि उन्होंने विश्वास किया तो था, लेकिन उसके बाद 26 जनवरी का वायलेंस हो गया, उस समय विश्वास किया तो था।
वायलेंस हमने पुलिस के साथ और प्रशासन के साथ और सरकार के साथ बैठकर रूट तय किए थे और उसमें जो जो कुछ हुआ है हमारी तरफ से युक्त मोर्चा
नहीं। लेकिन अगर कल को फिर ऐसा हो गया तो फिर उसकी जिम्मेदारी कौन लेगा? लोग पलट के सरकार को बोलेंगे कि आपने क्या किया?
संकेत जी, जो हमें रास्ता दिया गया उसमें गाड़ी आएगी, उसमें पुलिस, हमारा किसान दिल्ली में पला नहीं है, दिल्ली में रहता नहीं है, उनको रास्ते मालूम नहीं है। जब पुलिस उसको किसी भी रास्ते में डालेगी तो कहां जाएंगे? हमारा हमारा देश नहीं है ना, हमने तो वो रास्ता तय किया।
नहीं नहीं प्रगत जी, ऐसा है, ये जो लोग रेड फोर्ट गए थे उनको अच्छे से मालूम था कि लाल किले का रास्ता क्या है। ये इतने भी मासूम नहीं थे वो लोग जो लाल किले पहुंचे थे। उनका तो डिफेंड, उनको डिफेंड बिल्कुल भी नहीं किया जा सकता। आई थिंक इवन द फार्मर्स विल नॉट डिफेंड,
हम उनको डिफेंड भी कर रहे हैं, हम संयुक्त मोर्चा भी डिफेंड कर रहे हैं। संयुक्त मोर्चा की तरफ से कोई जब गए भी है उनको हमने
वापस। द ओनली लिमिटेड पॉइंट दैट वन इज मेकिंग, लास्ट वर्ड टू मिस्टर जैन। मिस्टर जैन,
ये हमारे साथ साजिश हुई है जी।
ओके मिस्टर जैन, लास्ट 30 seconds, आई वॉन्ट टू नो फ्रॉम यू, डू यू फील दैट देर आर ओनली टू स्टेक होल्डर्स हियर, एंड इफ द गवर्नमेंट as part of its responsibility, if it can restrict the conversation just to these two stakeholders, government and farmers, you will do a great deal of wellness for yourself as well as the farmers. And the moment you get into this narrative debate, the problem begins.
Yes, yes.
Do you think you've strayed away?
State में 30 सेकंड में जवाब दे रहा हूं। प्रधानमंत्री जी का ये कहना कि हम सिर्फ एक टेलीफोन कॉल पर दूर हैं। आज श्री नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर जी का राज्यसभा में कहना कि इस कानून में क्या काला है बताइए, हम चर्चा के लिए तैयार हैं, बातचीत के लिए तैयार हैं। मेरा निवेदन है दोनों पक्ष बैठें, किसान बातचीत के लिए आगे आए, सरकार बातचीत को तैयार है। उसके लिए अगर ये अपना आंदोलन स्थगित करके आएंगे तो हिंसा का खतरा भी कम हो जाएगा, किसानों की परेशानी भी कम हो जाएगी। लॉज पहले से ही होल्ड पर रखे हैं सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने, मुझे पूरा विश्वास है किसान नेता आगे आएंगे तो प्रधानमंत्री जी,
I think far more important than the honor versus insecurity debate is to fix a problem and look for solutions to the main issue, the core issue, which has been left festering for a very long time. Thank you very much, Naresh Sirohi, Satyapal Jain, Maheshinder Garewal, Ravinder Singh Cheema, as well as Pargat Singh Jamarai for joining us on this discussion. All right, joining us right now is Congress MP, Dr. Shashi Tharoor. Dr. Tharoor, thank you very much for joining us on The Big Fight. You know, the government coming out very openly against these tweets by international artists, big stars, big celebrities, big influencers, people of repute and recognition. The government says that this is an attempt to malign the image of the country because of a quote-unquote toolkit. Dr. Tharoor, you have had a lot of experience in dealing in international relations. You've also been the Minister of State for External Affairs. I want to know from you, Dr. Tharoor, what brings India disrepute? And does this qualify as bringing disrepute?
First of all, you know, in a democracy, we should hardly be surprised if people feel free to express their opinions. That's essentially what democracy is all about. And people in other democracies are equally used to saying what they like and expressing their views about everything, whether it's their concern, other countries, whatever. So for us to get all prickly and oversensitive about this is, to my mind, most unfortunate, because it makes us look as if we don't even fully respect the democracy we claim to be. Secondly, the problem is that we then take it so seriously. Our Ministry of External Affairs issues a statement bristling with indignation. We have ministers of the cabinet responding to these tweets by people like Rihanna and Greta Thunberg, who are popular, but popular amongst the general public, right? And by doing that, and then finally this FIR against a tweet with the so-called toolkit that you mentioned that Thunberg issued, we have actually made ourselves a laughingstock. So if you ask me what has brought us discredit, number one is the overreaction, the fact that we've issued a 6-paragraph rejoinder, facile counter hashtags from our government side, and then to link that thereafter to saying that this is our internal affairs, as if we ourselves don't comment on other countries' internal affairs. This is the same MEA that the previous day had rightly commented about concern on the Myanmar coup. So suddenly, the same country that had concerns about a domestic affair in Myanmar doesn't want a pop singer or an environmentalist of concerns about a human rights issue in our country, which seems, again, extremely silly. Third and equally irritating is this campaign to put up Indian celebrities against these Western celebrities. So we have a whole bunch of actors from Bollywood. We have a whole bunch of cricketers who are, of course, the two sets of people who are the biggest celebrities in our country. issuing tweets which have an embarrassing similarity to each other, suggesting thereby that some language or some templates were given to them by the authorities. So you have about 40 tweets all sounding alike with similar phrases. And then these tweets are supposed to be the answer to people like Rehan Anthonberg. But first of all, aside from the fact that the combined following of all our celebs enlisted to defend the government's honor on Twitter doesn't match the pair of Rehan Anthonberg. Doesn't match Rehan. She has 101 million by herself. There is also the fact, the basic fact, that our celebs' fans are overwhelmingly Indian, whereas the damage that the government is trying to counteract is damage done to the global image of India amongst foreigners. Mm. So all of this, I'm afraid, has really, really been embarrassing and discredited us. What our government should have done, it seems to me, was to take it in their stride with dignity, ignore it, because after a while, they would not have been able to sustain interest. In fact, their reaction has made the others double down. Greta Thunberg has issued one more tweet saying, I will not be cowed down by attempts to intimidate me and so on. Why are we doing this? You know, the only thing we need to do as a country is to go back to the qualities that made us so attractive in the world, which is that we were the land of the better story, as they say in talking about soft power. You must be the land of the better story. And here was India's story. It's a free market democracy, with our domestic politics offering an unparalleled example of the successful management of diversity in a free and open society. Hmm. Instead, we are now conveying the impression of a thin-skinned, bigoted government that's cracking down on dissent, slapping sedition charges against journalists and against an MP, going ahead and arresting journalists for trying to do their job. And the result, of course, the continued problems with the farmers' protests. We have such a relentless drumbeat of negative press in the Western world and in most countries, not just the Western world. That's what's discrediting us, Sanket.
Dr. Tharoor, I mean, you have also been a recipient of a similar FIR and action. Now, I want to know from you, what does this say of the government? Because if you speak to the government, they seem to suggest that, you know, we have to counter a nefarious design at play, which is causing harm and can potentially create trouble on the ground. So if something goes wrong, then, of course, these very set of people will turn around and say, why did the government not act? That's how they justify.
So the government should certainly act, and one of the ways they could act is by settling this problem before it gets totally out of control. You do not want farmers, particularly from Punjab and Haryana, and of course, Western UP, sort of heartland of our agriculture, to feel alienated and resentful. Many of them, of course, are their same families. One son is a farmer, another son is a jawan on the borders. You don't want those people being demoralized, that their families are being disrespected. The government should have taken this seriously, should have nipped it in the bud. It's gone on 75 days, which is an absolute disgrace. It should have been settled within 7, not 75. And I think that that's something the government really ought to do. Because what the world thinks about us matters more than ever before. Because as this week's budget has reminded us, we are in an economic crisis. Mm. We need more external trade, more investment, more goodwill. But foreign investment is an act of trust and faith in the future. And that is only going to be there if people think India is a great story that they want to be part of. If our image is eroding abroad, then I'm afraid the kind of sectarian, narrow, party political, petty objectives will come against and will undermine the national objective of ensuring that India really appeals to the world as a country that, frankly, is on the right track, bringing its people along in the narrative of development and growth that we want to sell the world.
Another point that is being made is, and of course, this is not officially by the government, but a lot of people who propagate the views of the government, that it's this strong position that India seems to be taking, which irks ecosystems across the globe. And that's why they conspire. And which is why, you know, a counter-narrative has to be mounted.
But you see, what is the counter-narrative? To my mind, the only counter-narrative that will actually have any credibility globally is a revival of democratic practice and inclusive politics. If India is once again seen as a country where we can manage all our differences and our diversities in this vast and diverse land in a democratic way, that will get us applause. Being, frankly, you know, trying to be tough and and slap charges against people and threaten lawsuits and lock up people. Now, this business about shutting down the internet has been particularly received badly abroad because people see the internet as something basic to their life, as basic as water and electricity. In fact, in some Western countries, Finland, for example, internet is deemed a human right. Mm. And here is the government shutting down the internet in many parts in and around Delhi. That doesn't go over well at all. And on top of that, you want to say that you have a better narrative? This is not a good narrative. A narrative of being a government that is bigoted, that's intolerant, that's chauvinist, that is driving wedges between its people, that's promoting majoritarianism, that's cutting the internet, that's locking up journalists.
But you know, Dr. Tharoor,
you think that's a good image?
Dr. Tharoor, the government's explanation for having done all of this is that they trusted and allowed all of this. And then suddenly you had the events of the January 26th, which is why, as a precautionary measure, they have to do this.
Well, I certainly want condign and exemplary punishment for those who misbehaved on the 26th. I myself tweeted that day, the first tweet I issued on Republic Day was deploring what had happened, saying I've supported the farmers throughout, but I cannot and will not condone lawlessness. And that the only flag that should have been allowed to fly on the Red Fort that day is the sacred Tiranga. My point of view has been very clear. And those who disrupted, many of whom seem to be very close to extremely prominent BJP leaders, I mean, there are photographs on the internet showing these fellows who actually invaded the Red Fort and strung up the flag as being inspired and supported by the BJP. They should certainly be identified, brought to book and punished. And we are not at all opposed to that.
Sure.
So using 26 January as an excuse for the overall behavior of the government doesn't make sense. It should only be a justification for taking action against those who misbehaved on the 26th.
Okay.
Look, my view very clearly is the government can only change our international image by changing its own conduct, not by issuing hashtags.
Okay. I think that's a strong statement. My final question, do you think that the fight for controlling narratives has boiled down to a debate between, in these polarized times, a debate between honor versus insecurity?
See, but honor is extremely subjective and personal. What makes a person or a family or an institution feel their honor is besmirched will depend on the circumstances. Certainly the farmers do feel disrespected. Now, the government may say that its honor has been insulted by what happened 26th January, and I'm in favor of taking action against it. Whose honor is affected by a pop singer issuing a tweet, for God's sake? Is India's honor so fragile that that will actually damage our honor? We should have a better sense of self-respect and honor than that.
Sure. Dr. Tharoor, thank you so much for joining us on The Big Fight.
Thank you, Sanket.